today we are going to learn about another important modal auxiliary called may. May is the most favorite month for all students, because it is the only month where they don't have to go to schools or colleges. But at the same time, it is also a very painful month, because May is the only month where we find temperature going plus 40 plus and 42 plus. So May is called a modal auxiliary in English language. And let me tell you, it can go with all the persons. You can use it for first person, second person, third person, and you can use with verbs and other parts of speech. Now look at this example. The sky is cloudy. It may rain. What is the meaning of this example? The sky is cloudy, it may rain.
There is a chance to rain.
There are chances. Because whenever there are clouds, there is no guarantee that it rains. But chances are there. So that is where we use may. When you are not sure, when you are not clear, when you are not certain, when you are doubtful, when you are talking in terms of chances, we use may. So the summary of all these words, to put it in one word, we call it probability, P-R-O, probability, probability, may be or may not be. You are not sure, you are not clear, you are not certain, you are not definite, you are quite doubtful. Chances are there, equal chances, 50 and 50 chances are there. So this is called cause, this is called probable effect, this is cause, this is probable effect. It is quite simple. If I give the cause, I am sure you can make the sentence on your own. The sky is clear. What to write here?
It may not rain.
Very good, good. It may not rain. I am cautioning a young boy like this. You are standing on the edge of the wall. Think of some sentence here.
You may slip.
You may fall. You may slip. You may lose your balance. Good. You may fall. A mother is talking to her young child like this. Please stop playing in rain. Please stop playing in rain.
You may be affected.
You may suffer from cold.
You may suffer from cold. You may fall sick. You may catch cold. These are called probabilities. Now, how are we making sentences? Let me show you. Take any subject of your choice. I, we, you, he, she, it, they, singular or plural name. Then you take may. After that, you can keep base form of the verb. Or you can keep the word be, or you can keep the word have. You can use any of these three. I'll give you the examples. He has exams. He may be in his study room. This is the probability. He has exams, he is preparing for examinations. Don't search for him here and there. He may be in his study room. Next one, they are school going children. They may have color pencils. Borrow from them. You need color pencils. So I am talking to you like this. They are school going children. Please go to them. They may have, chances are there, they may have color pencils. Borrow from them. So here I am using have, which indicates a position. When you are talking about doubtful position, you need have. When you are talking about doubtful quality or doubtful place or prepositions or adjectives, you need this one. When you are talking about actions, verbs, work, you need base form. And every sentence can be used in only two ways. We do not have the question forms. We have only positive and negative statement. He may come, he may not come. He may be busy, he may not be busy. He may have experience, he may not have experience. She may be active, she may not be active. She may go, she may not go. She may have leisure, she may not have leisure. Look at the board. He may resign. What is the negative form? He may not resign. He may resign meaning the chances are there. The chances of resigning are there. He may not resign. The chances are less. The chances are not there. Next one. He may be at home. There are chances. What is the negative form? He may not be at home. The chances are less. Next one. He may have experience. What is the negative form?
He may not have experience.
He may not have experience. Fine. Positive and negative forms. We do not have the question forms. Now let me test you. I give the causes. Orally you tell me the effects by using may or may not. We need 8 runs to win the match and we have 2 balls.
We may not win.
We may not win. Any other example? It may be difficult. It may not be possible. Fine. You are eating lot of junk food these days. Tell me the effect.
You may suffer.
You may suffer. You may fall sick. Please stop irritating the dog. Please stop irritating the dog.
It may bite you.
It may bite you. It may attack you. It may get angry. You have been coming home very late these days. Your parents are not happy with you. Try to put something here.
They may scold you.
They may scold you or they may get angry. You haven't been attending the classes regularly. Your attendance is quite less. After that?
You may not be.
You may not get hall ticket or the principal may warn you. You haven't been studying regularly for a very long time. After this,
you may fail.
You may fail. You may not be able to score more marks or you may not get good percentage of marks. You have the habit of riding rashly. You have the habit of riding very fast. Stop doing that.
Others may not understand.
You may make an accident or you may meet with an accident. Why do you apply the brake suddenly? You have the bad habit of applying the brake suddenly. Please don't do that. The vehicle may skid off the road. Fine. How many ice creams will you eat? Please stop eating ice creams. Say something after that.
You may fall
sick. You may develop throat infection. You may catch cold. I have seen the movie. Wonderful, excellent. It has all the ingredients which a common man needs. After that,
it may be a
big hit.
It may become blockbuster.
Blockbuster. People may enjoy this movie. Now, how did you develop the sentences? Did you touch any grammar book? Did you do any exercise? No. I gave the cause. You use your own mind for this cause. What is the suitable effect? That is what we have to do. As far as possible, we should resist the temptation of touching a grammar book and doing exercises. We will not develop our own spontaneity. We have to look at the surroundings. Wherever there is a scope to develop a sentence, make a sentence. So this is about probability. Apart from this, may is also used for permissions. Please recollect the first sentence which you used in your school when you came late, when you were coming late at the entrance of your classroom. You stood and what did you say?
May I come in, sir?
Yes, this is one of the commonly used sentences by any school boy. May I come in? What is the meaning of this sentence? Permission. You are using this. Now, you want to know my name.
May I know your name?
May I know your name? You are in hurry. You want to go now.
May I leave, sir?
May I leave? Very good. May I leave? You want to ask a question?
May I ask you a question, sir?
May I ask you a question? You do not have a pen.
May I borrow your pen?
May I borrow your pen or may I use this pen? Now, here there is a point. In case of probability, you can use for all the three persons. I said that. But in case of permissions, you cannot use it for all the three persons. It is possible only with first person, singular and plural. May I come in? May we come in? May I go out? May we go out? May I know your name? May we know your name? May I get a glass of water? May we get a glass of water? May I leave now? May we leave now? Please give me five examples for permissions.
May I borrow the book?
Very good. May I borrow the book?
May I have some water?
May I have some water?
May I sit
here? May I sit here?
May I come here?
May I come here? May I know the details of taking membership in the library?
Good. May I ask you a question?
May I ask you a question?
May I take the number?
Right. Good. Very good. So the first one is probability and the second one is permission. So first point, you should understand the structure of the sentence, how to develop the sentence. Second point, you should try to know the situation. This is how to make a sentence. This is when to use that sentence. After that, forms. What are the other forms for that sentence? What are the positive forms, negative forms, question forms, statement forms? You have to make sure how many forms does it have. After gaining knowledge, then the next step that you have to do is make own sentences. Think, make own sentences. But do not be in a hurry to do grammar exercises and solve some questions and answers. Make own sentences. And how? With pen or with tongue? With tongue. Orally. Loudly. Because your job is to train the tongue. When you practice loudly, remember, confidence increases. Loudness is always an indication of confidence. We see in the parliament and in the assembly meetings how the leaders confidently defend themselves, how confidently they talk. So when you raise your voice, raise in the sense you should be audible up to 5 meters, minimum 5 and maximum 10 meters. It should be audible. When you practice loudly, tongue gets the training and confidence increases, and at the same time, clarity comes. People will not ask you, could you repeat please, louder please, could you raise your voice. They need not say that. So while practicing, please keep these two points in mind. So I hope you have understood how to use may. So keep making own examples at home. Next class, we shall learn about one more topic. Have a great time.
Thank you, sir.
Now, listen to two friends discussing some important issue.
Hi, Varsha. Good morning.
Good morning, Mansi.
Do you want to go get a burger to eat today afternoon?
A burger? Rather than a burger, why don't we eat something a little more healthy? You know, burger comes under junk food.
Yeah, but what is there in junk food? It's tasty, right?
It is tasty, but you know, it is so dangerous. It is absolutely not healthy.
Okay, then tell me more about junk food then. Let me also learn.
Okay, see, junk food is nothing but a pre-prepared snack or a packaged food.
Okay.
What happens is junk food is very tasty to look at and to your eyes and to your mouth.
Yeah.
Because what we do as humans is first it should be appealing to the eyes and then to the mouth.
Yeah.
And that is how junk foods are prepared.
I agree.
True. Now, junk food is nothing but these are high on calories, on fat and on carbohydrates and on sugar compared to their nutrition value. Junk is nothing but scrap or useless in English, and it is aptly named for such kind of food category, which is called as junk food.
But isn't things like carbohydrates and sugar, isn't it good for the body?
Carbohydrates and sugar, yes, but only to a very minute extent. What the body needs is proteins, minerals, nutrients.
Okay.
And those are absolutely not there in junk food. The actual meaning of junk food itself, a food which is high on sugar, carbohydrates and very low on nutrition value.
So it is junk, it is not good.
It is absolutely not good. Just like the name suggests, it is junk and fast food.
But then even my younger brothers and sisters are having junk food. It should be very bad for them also.
Exactly. I mean, just imagine the kind of attraction a junk food creates to us. Now, you said, why don't we have a burger? Burger is of course tasty, and you just don't end up having a burger. You get a burger along with a fry or along with a cold drink again over there.
Yeah.
If not for that, then there are pizzas. If not for that, you have gums, chewing gums, a lot of sugar-based chewing gums. Mm. If not for that, then you have candies.
Yeah.
Sugar candies. You have a lot of desserts. Desserts, I cannot even imagine to begin my list. There are so many types and kinds of desserts and so tasty, so appealing to us. And just imagine what kind of impression this varied variety of tasty junk would be creating on the mind of a child.
Yeah, I agree. Then it's not at all good for children. Maybe you should tell more about that. Can you tell me how we can help, how the junk food does not help children, or can you tell me how I can help my younger brothers and sisters avoid eating junk
food? See, not many of them are aware that we all know that junk food is not healthy, but we are not aware to what extent it is unhealthy.
Okay.
We are not aware of its consequences, of its side effects, basically.
Okay.
The thing is, junk food is very appealing. It is tasty.
Yeah.
And it is attracting even the children these days. Children as young as 4 or 5 are on junk food.
Yeah.
They start with chocolates. Chocolates is sweet. They may not understand the taste of salt and spice, but they will understand the taste of sweet.
Yes.
And knowingly or unknowingly, even the people or the members around them are encouraging to eat such kind of sweet because the child is liking it.
Yeah.
Now, if they're eating, how can you say no to a child?
Yeah.
So that is how they end up encouraging, knowingly or unknowingly, they end up encouraging to, you know, let them have that kind of sweet.
Yeah.
And it is very saddening to say that schools and colleges these days are also serving nothing but junk food. Because cost-wise, it is fine for them. It is good for them. They are able to save a lot of money because it's all pre-cooked. And when it comes to serving children, children are able to have because it is tasty. It is easily available. It is very cheap. It is not so expensive. And it is available at their school or at their doorstep also. It is not somewhere far where you have to, you know, travel a distance.
Yeah.
What happens is the more you're eating junk food, the more you are craving for such kind of food, the sugar, the carbohydrates in that food is creating an addiction in your brain.
Hmm.
That is making you unknowingly crave for such kind of food.
So you're saying that if I eat a lot of junk food, then at some point of time, no matter what meal I have, I will always ask for some junk food?
There will be
that
such kind of
craving. That is called addiction, right?
That is called addiction. No matter how tasty the home-cooked food is, people generally tend to go, today is a weekend. Why not we all go out and celebrate? Why not we go to a restaurant? Why not we go somewhere else? Why not we go to a burger joint? Why not we go to a pizza joint? Why should a weekend celebration end at burger or pizza joint? Why can't it be together with your family and spend some quality time with them? They tend to imagine that what is available outside is much more tasty. That is how their mind is reacting to junk food.
Then what would you suggest to children, or even some of our viewers will have younger brothers and sisters, right?
True.
So what would you suggest to them that should be given to the children in place of junk food? What do you suggest?
Before I tell what is better to substitute in the place of junk food cravings, let me tell what are the, you know, dangerous side effects that these junk food have. The first and foremost thing, junk food have major effects, especially on children. The first will be its adverse reaction on their mental growth. The studies have proven that the mental activity of the brain, the behavior of the brain, the way you tend to move along, the way you work, the way your memory is, everything is affected because of junk food. Because junk food doesn't take anything good, anything nutrition back to your brain. Mm. There is nothing good in eating that junk food. And what a child needs and what a growing child needs is proper protein, proper nutrition, proper mineral food. And junk food obviously doesn't do that. And unknowingly, the mental health is very much affected. You can see that in their academic level or compared to their friends, the way they behave, the way their mental ability is, it will slow down. Eventually, it will slow down. Studies have proven this this fact.
Okay.
The next will be, there will be a nutrition deficiency, which is obvious thing to happen.
That's true.
Because your junk food has only sugar, carbohydrates, which is not good.
And most of junk food is fried or boiled, so that kills all the nutrients in the food.
Completely
also.
It kills, and especially, okay, for example, we are talking about fried foods. Fried food, the best example will be your potato chips that are available. Now, are these potatoes, most of them, they are not even the organic or the properly grown potatoes. They are processed potatoes, in fact. They are those hybrid varieties which are not grown in the normal condition, and as long as it hits the boiling oil, any vegetable, any bread, any item that hits the boiling oil,
the nutrients are gone.
It is fried completely, fried to into nothingness. That is how it is lost, and they'll end up having nutrition deficiency, and that will lead to having a vitamin substitution, having another substitution. Instead of, you know, having good food and home cooked food and food with proteins, they'll end up having medicines in the place of normal food because they have such kind of deficiencies now.
And that will also lead to some diseases also.
That will lead to diseases, and most common diseases we see are fatigue, anemia and insomnia. Fatigue is nothing but extreme tiredness. Complete tiredness, your lack of energy, you're not in a position to mentally or physically do any work. We don't see this happening overnight, but gradually, yes, this definitely happens. And then this will lead to anemia. Anemia is nothing but a stage where the red blood cells, the count of it will reduce, and that will reduce in your hemoglobin, which is very essential for the body to pump oxygen.
Okay.
Just imagine what kind of damage it will create to a child of that age. And then insomnia. Insomnia is nothing but the inability to sleep on time. And these are all affecting a child who is growing right from the age of 6. Imagine if a child is going through all these health issues, how dangerous it would be.
So at the young age, if they are getting those kind of problems, then maybe in older age they can get things like diabetes, and some more problems like tuberculosis, everything could come.
Absolutely. There are 100% chances that over the age, it will lead to such kind of problems. And the most common problem that we see is obesity.
Obesity, yeah.
Obesity is nothing but being excessively fat.
Fat, being very fat.
Being very, very fat. Not just fat, being excessively fat to an extent that it will again lead to further more complications. You know, being excessively fat or obesity will slowly lead to low self-esteem.
Oh.
Because everybody, as a child and as an adolescent or as an adult, you care a lot of how you look, how you dress, what you wear, everything you care about it. True. Mm. And the more you're looking not so appealing to your own eyes, you tend to a little demean or underestimate or undermine yourself slowly and slowly. And that will create low self-esteem. And there are chances that it will lead to depression also. We see that happening to an extent that, you know, almost 40% of children and adolescents are dealing with low self-esteem and depression. Not everybody understands that the main reason for this is junk food, because food is like fuel to your body. Without food, you cannot think of growing, of developing your body, your mental and your physical health.
Mm.
That is what they don't understand, and it will lead to, like you said, diabetes, and especially type 2 diabetes, which is very common among children, we have seen. And it will slowly lead to respiratory disorders, because if there's a lot of fat, a lot of congestion in your body and not able to breathe, it will lead to respiratory disorders, and in future some your heart diseases also. Every doctor has said that the main reason for all of this will only be junk food and nothing else.
Okay.
Because there is no proper protein in your body. There is no proper nutrients in your body to build the immune system to fight against such kind of diseases in the first place.
Okay. So this is what, you know, when you're telling me about all of these things, I'm reminded of a very popular quote which says, you are what you eat. If you don't eat nutritious food and if you eat junk food, then you will naturally be unhealthy.
Exactly.
So, after you tell me all this, I have an idea. So, my younger brothers and sisters, you're telling me that children like to eat food which is very colorful and exciting.
Have you seen desserts like, you know, any kind of sweets or cupcakes or donuts? They're arranged with such colorful cream on top with nice sprinklers. It is so appealing to anybody's eye. Yeah. You feel like taking a bite.
So what I should do probably next time is, I should make nutritious food like vegetables and fruits. If I can arrange it in a very colorful way, in shapes of animals on a plate, maybe my younger
in
brothers
shape
and
of
sisters.
Animals in the shape of flowers.
Yeah.
And now I think all children are a very big fan of a lot of superheroes.
Yeah.
Right from Chota Bheem to Pokemon to their favorite hero on the TV.
Yeah.
If they can arrange something like a story, like a movie, like a small star, or like a beam with his any of his accessory, I think that will be very appealing
to
their eyes.
Yeah, so I can use things like, I can use capsicums for some green color. If I want to put flowers, I can use carrots, and I can use all sorts of vegetables and fruits. Make it look colorful, so maybe that way my younger brothers and sisters will want to eat it, and they are eating healthy food, right?
They are eating healthy food, true. We should spend a little more time on making children aware that don't have such kind of cravings where you will, instead of going straight home and eating, go tangential towards the junk food. They have to, you know, they should be given that proper awareness that junk food is completely harmful to you, and this is how you should plan your meal. They should be able to have healthy breakfast, nutritious breakfast, a heavy breakfast if possible at home. Home cooked food are always the best. We have right from dosas, idlis, poha to uttapam to you name it, including rice and your dal. They are the best home cooked food available, and they are packed with nutrition, they are packed with protein. Have heavy breakfast. Plan their meal on time. Children may not do it on their own. We can all help them do it.
Yeah.
And you can, instead of giving them any sort of unhealthy snack, why don't we give them some dry fruits and nuts?
Dry fruits and also a good idea. So I'll take some of these ideas. I'll give it to my brothers and sisters, and I think some of our viewers will also have siblings.
True. So, and I should also tell, please be aware that junk food is absolutely not good for your health, for your mental or for your physical health. Studies have said that over the next 10 years, America will see the population of around 40% of American population will reach its obesity level.
Oh.
And that means one in every third person will be obese. Not just fat, please, it is obese.
We should imagine
the kind of danger it is posing.
I understand. We should make sure that does not happen in our India.
True, true. Given that junk food stalls are available everywhere, around the corner they're available. I mean, we should be careful what to eat, what not to eat. And let us all help our children, our younger siblings, to be more aware and help them eat more healthy food for their own health and for a better future with no illness at all.
Let us listen to a story.
As long as I live, so long do I learn. See how wonderful the title is. Means we are ever learners. We learn something and we feel like learning some more. And if we cease to learning, there the end is. Socrates was one of the wisest men of the city of Athens. You know where Athens is? Athens is the capital of Greece, where many great philosophers were born. Socrates was
one of those greatest philosophers. Often he stood at the street corners, gathered young men around him, asked them questions, and helped them find answers on their own. See, now the education system has become very monotonous and a rote mechanism too. Teachers here dictate the answers. Students are busy in just memorizing them and again writing them in the exams and just simply throwing them into the trash cans. But unlike this, Socrates wanted the students to learn by eliciting the answers themselves. Means there was a challenge in front of them. They must work hard to find out the answers. The members of the city council felt that Socrates was turning the young man against them. Those days, the whole power was in the hands of the church. And those city council, which was made of clergy, they had the power and they used to rule the kingdom too. So they found that Socrates was a revolutionist and he was just making the youngsters to revolt against the king. They ordered his arrest on charge of sedition. This sedition is also the same thing, like inspiring some people or just making them turn against the country and the king too. He was tried and sentenced to death. So they call him as a traitor and they tried him and sentenced to death. The date of his execution was fixed and Socrates was detained in prison. So execution, they wanted him to die either by hanging him till death or by giving him poison. So they opted for the second one. It was decided that on the appointed day, he would be made to drink a glass of hemlock, a deadly poison. Socrates had a large circle of friends and followers. They came every day to the prison and spent hours talking to him. They found him calm and composed. See, a person who learns philosophy and who observes philosophy in his life is always cool and composed. Such kind of person will never be shattered at the time of difficulty too. He did not show the slightest sign of fear. His attitude seemed to say, "Death, do thy worst. I, for one, am not scared." Thy is, in olden English, thy is your. So, death, do your worst. I, for one, am not scared. Even our Rabindranath Tagore said the same. When the god of death comes to my house, I won't send him empty-handed. Such great the people are. A few days before his execution, a musical tune wafted into the cell through the window. Wafting is coming slowly through the wind, which opened out to the road beyond the prison wall, on the other side of the prison wall. Socrates walked to the window and looked out. He saw an old man sitting with his back to the trunk of a tree, strumming on his harp. Harp is a musical instrument, and strumming is nothing but moving their hands on the strings up and down. Socrates turned to his friends and said, "That music is truly divine." You know what is divine? Divine is holy, pure. I wish I could learn to sing that song. Can you get hold of the singer and bring him to me? His friends were taken aback. Taken aback means surprised. And they were shocked too. They asked, "Why do you want to meet him?" "I want to learn that tune. It's truly divine," Socrates replied. "Why waste effort? You know you are going to die in less than a week, a friend pointed out. This friend was really sad about Socrates' death, but he was astonished too with the wish of the Socrates of learning music. So he couldn't control himself, asking, so why waste of effort? You know you are going to die in less than a week. If he were a common man, he would have lost his heart thinking about his death. But Socrates, as I said, a great philosopher, for him, death or life, both are same. Victory or failure, both are alike. That is all the more the reason why I must learn that tune. I won't get a chance again. Please hurry up, get hold of the singer. Otherwise, we may not be able to trace him, and I will never learn that tune. Socrates appealed to his friends. So he requested his friends to rush up and find the singer and get him to him. One of them went to the prison official and presented the request of Socrates. Prison official is like our jailer. The officials who held Socrates in great esteem, means they had a great respect towards Socrates, sent a guard to fetch the singer. A little later, the guard returned, leading the singer to Socrates. After polite exchanges, Socrates requested the singer, means after greeting him and after asking after him, he just requested him, will you please teach me that tune? It is truly soulful music. He praised the singer for his talent in music and requested him to teach him that tune. The singer sat down and went over and over the musical notes. These musical notes are the words and sounds which are in the music. Socrates repeated them. For nearly 2 hours, he practiced. Look at his concentration and look at his determination. How well, like a new learner, as just an amateur learner, he practiced it for 2 hours. Then the singer said, you know it well. Oh, revered sir, you can sing it as well as I can. The singer was also really shocked and surprised at the determination of this Socrates. And he just appreciated Socrates for his concentration and for his learning, the fast learning talent also. So you also can learn English and any other thing if you can concentrate on it well, like Socrates. Thank you. Today I'm better informed than I was yesterday. Every day till death, I want to learn something new. It is never too late to learn. I repeat the sentence. It is never too late to learn. Okay? I think you got it. Thank you for teaching me the tune. Socrates sent the man away respectfully. Great people are very humble. When you look at Dr. Abdul Kalam too, you can find him multi-talented, but he's very humble. Knowledge is vast. Nobody, however studious he may be, ever learns everything. So nobody is a scholar. So a scholar also, a professor also, a master who mastered in many things also is a learner forever. The wise man knows more today than yesterday. Every day he increases his knowledge. Knowledge is nothing but knowing things. So we must prepare ourselves to know many things day by day. So every day dawns with a new knowledge and it ends with a satisfaction of learning something. So we are eager to wait for another day to know more things. The quest for knowledge is never ending. Thank you.
Now, listen to this parable and try to find out the language elements.
Hi Manasi.
Hello Varsha.
You know, I told you long back that I wanted to learn a foreign language.
Mm-hmm.
So, I finally started with German language.
Oh, very good. Good choice.
It is. Finally, when I got my books, my textbook and my classes started and I opened the books, I started to learn and read. It was so difficult. Not one grammar concept, not one word or those sentences, they're nothing similar to any language that I learned so far. It feels so difficult for me to learn, difficult for me to even understand.
Mm.
The voice, the tone, the pronunciation, everything is so difficult.
Mm.
Sometimes, you know, I feel I may not be able to achieve this by the end of the day. I'm thinking of giving it up.
No, don't give it up. You know what? Anything that you want to do, you will have difficulties, Varsha. Okay, let me make a comparison.
Okay.
I'll tell you an analogy in the form of a little story.
Okay.
So once there was a beautiful lush garden. Okay. And in this garden, there were all sorts of flowers.
Hmm.
There were tulips. There were hibiscus flowers. Hibiscus ante mandara pugulu.
Okay.
Then there were chrysanthemums.
Hmm.
There were those tiny white flowers with five petals. In Telugu, we call it Garudavardhani.
Okay.
And then there were also beautiful roses.
Oh.
In all colors. White, red, pink roses, yellow roses.
Oh, roses are my favorite.
Yeah, roses are beautiful flowers. So, the garden was filled with it. And wherever you go, you're getting that aroma, that lovely smell of the flowers.
Hmm.
So, once there was a child walking in this garden.
Okay.
And the child spotted a plant of roses.
Hmm.
And it saw at the top, there was a beautiful lush pink rose.
Oh.
And it wanted to pluck the rose and smell it.
Okay.
So, it reached up his hand and tried to take the rose flower.
Hmm.
But when the child did that, the thorns on the stem of the rose began to poke the child's hand.
Oh.
And it was not able to reach for the flower. In the same way, when you're trying to learn German, you're finding obstacles when you're trying to reach your goal of learning the German language. But remember, anything that is beautiful, anything that is worth succeeding for does not come easy. There will be obstacles, there will be difficulties, but you should make sure that you don't lose your spirit.
True.
You should be perseverant, you should motivate yourself and overcome the difficulties because it is not impossible. You tell me, if it is so impossible to learn German, how are there German pandits?
How are there
so many people in the world learning German?
That is true.
All overcame because they said, even though there are difficulties, I will still persevere. Kashtalu ochina, I will still keep trying and never stop till I reach my goal.
Exactly. I should also be careful about it. And my zeal to learn German language should not be given up so easy.
Don't give up that easy. Don't give up just yet.
Absolutely
not. Keep trying until you reach your goal.
I will pursue it. Thank you so much.
Yeah.